Welcome back to my channel. I'm here with another video. I'm doing another highly requested video. You guys have been wanting me and asking me and telling me to talk about uni. I don't even know where to begin. I don't know what to say to you guys. I hate this topic so much, like, gosh. But I'm here making the content you guys asked for, so make sure you like. Make sure you comment, make sure you subscribe to, tell your friend to watch this, make sure you watch this, save it when you go to uni, make sure your sister watches it, tell everyone to watch it. So today's video, I'm going to be telling you guys the do's and the don'ts of uni, because a lot of you have gotten your results and are going to university, might be going to first year, could be going to second year, third year, vice versa. Uni's uni, so I'm here to tell you guys what I've learned, what I know, and what you should do, what you shouldn't do, maybe to give you guys a small insight so that if you're nervous, you can prepare and just kind of get a gist of what uni is. I would say the first don't is to not pick a course that you won't enjoy, or not picking a course for the sake of picking a course. Like, guys, uni is a big thing. You're gonna have to dedicate 3 years of your life. Like, if you thought A-levels was hard, even though A-levels is still the worst thing that could have ever been done, uni, uni is 10 times worse. Like, you think it gets easy? You people that have done summer holiday, enjoy this summer holiday, because life gets worse. You're about to walk into hell. You think, yeah, uni, party, lifestyle, minor, degree, no. So I would say it's really important to pick something that you're actually going to enjoy, because one, you're paying for it, two, you actually have to attend the lectures to learn and do exams, so make it worth your while. Another don't, I would say, is do not splash your student finance recklessly. Okay, guys, I know we get a little bit gasped, we've got money coming in. Remember, you have rent to pay and you actually need to survive. If you don't have a job on the side, part-time job, this is what you're gonna be living off. So don't say, okay, first student finance, let me go to Selfridges, let me get takeaway every single day. No. Leading on to that, I would say one do is learn how to cook. Don't suffer, you know. Don't be one of them people who's going to uni and don't know how to cook. Nobody's going to cook for you. Your mum's not going to be there. Your family's not going to be there. The only thing saving you is if you're going with friends, you may be able to take turns. So be prepared to do grocery shopping on your own. Cooking, if that's meal prepping, if that's knowing what you want to eat, what you don't want to eat. And sometimes you might not want to cook. You might want to get takeaway. That's fine. You can do that. But remember, this money's got to stretch. And gonna get this out of the way from now, guys. Avoid entanglements, yeah? Avoid boys, avoid crying, avoid being a uni wife to my ladies, avoid even guys, avoid girls and complications and situations. Just remember what you're going to uni for. Like, everyone gets a bit excited, and you know, you think you're gonna find your husband, you think you're gonna find your wife. Second year of uni, no husband has been found, but you know, we can talk about that. Gosh, don't even remind me. I really thought I was one of them people, like, oh my god, yeah, I'm gonna go to uni, I'm gonna find my husband. Hey, what husband have I found? Oh wait, you lot tell me, find him for me as well. Cool. So yeah, with the avoid being a uni wife, girls, this is to my ladies. Some big people, boys, they go to uni, they can't cook. Like, yeah, I'm just gonna pack on one girl and she's gonna cook for me. I mean, sometimes they might be your friends, you wanna help them out, you might wanna cook for them, but don't let them take the mick out of you. Tell them to buy their own groceries as well. You want me to cook? Fine, I'll cook for us, but contribute something as well. Don't be eating off my student finance and buying designer drip with yours. Like, let's not deal with that. I would say, guys, do go to your lectures, okay? Like, you might have some 9 a.m. here, you might have some 11 a.m, 1 p.m, 2 p.m, whatever it is, try to go to these lectures, because again, this is the only time you get contact with your lecturers, your teachers, the people who are teaching you. Outside of that, it's just a PowerPoint online, and sometimes we can teach ourselves online, but again, we're paying 9k to be taught. So try and go to your lectures. If you miss a lecture, try email your lecturer, ask them if there's anything else you missed out, because another thing lecturers like to do, what they taught in the lesson and what they put online, two different things. You go onto the online lesson, you're like, what did you even do? You talk about group discussion, you wasn't in the class, we don't even know what discussion. I would say, guys, make friends also with people on your course, so that when you do miss lessons, you can talk to them, and also socialize people in your course, because those are the people that will help you in times of need. Shout out all my people that on my course that I do get along with, and we can discuss and help each other. I would say first year, I didn't really socialize with people on my course. I don't know if I was nervous, so I just wanted to keep to just go into lecture and going home. But towards the end, until second year, I did make friends with quite a few people on my course, and it's actually the best thing ever because they're the ones who will get you the most. You might be going with other friends or people you meet outside of your course, but they will never know the true struggle of what you're going through on your course. Just mingle with people because uni is like your prime years of being young. Like, you're gonna meet so many different people, loads of people. You're gonna meet new friends who will literally probably be your life friends, and they're gonna teach you loads of things along the way. But saying that, everyone you meet is good for you, and not everyone is your friend, and not everyone you must be involved with. So I would say be wary, be aware, stay alert. Not everyone's your friend. Some people are just associates, so let's not get carried away in the gist of being at uni, because this is how unnecessary dramas, beef and arguments happen, guys. Just be you. Oh, another thing, be you at uni, yeah? Just because you've left Peckham, you've left Edmonton, and you've gone to the Midlands, or you've gone to wherever, people know you, so let's not forget, okay? Let's not get carried away. Freshers. Freshers Week is amazing, because this is where everyone's come fresh from their cities, they want to party. I don't know about this year, because Corona, COVID-19 is here, so I don't know how fresh it is going to work, but there's going to be a lot of parties, guys. Enjoy them for like the first month. You know what, the first year, parties non-stop, guys. It's not every party you must go to. Like, sometimes it's actually okay to rest. You don't want to be that person at every single party, like everyone's tired of your face. Like, be known, but let's not be too known. Let's not get carried away. Let's remember what your parents sent you off to uni, okay? And while you're there, guys, do your assignments on time. Oh, I need to take my own advice. I'm now going into third year and I need to take this advice. Do your assignments on, you know, if you can do it when they give it to you, they're on the spot, it. Trust me, you will thank me later. Do not leave your assignments to the last minute. There's no point. It's rush, probably gonna get a low grade, all for that. Guys, take uni seriously, yeah? Let's not mess around, because first year's all fun and games, okay? You have small messing about, but you need to pass first year to get to second year. Second year is where your grades count to go to third year. So again, cut the messing about. Do all the tomfoolery in first year, but remember, you need to get to second year. Don't be afraid to message your lecturers and ask them for extra help if you don't understand something, because that's what they're there for. Some of my lecturers, they don't want to hear it, they don't want to know, but you have to pressure them, and not because you're in most of these classes, there's a lot of people in there, so they tend to forget about you. They probably don't even know your name. Like, half of my lecturers don't know me personally, just probably know me by face. But you need to be like, hello, hi, this is my work, can you check it? How can I improve? I need help, I don't understand this. It's okay to ask questions. Other thing, guys, I would say, be mindful of who you choose to pick to live with, even in second year, first year, shared accommodation. Like, when you're doing your shopping, like, you know, like, do lots of bulk shopping. Like, I would personally say bulk shopping makes a lot of sense, because you have everything you need in bulk and you save money. Let's think about it. But like, in places where you're sharing fridges and accommodation or kitchen, whatever, it's a bit hard to do that, because, you know, we get people who steal food and steal stuff. So do keep some of your stuff in your room, not everything you must put in the kitchen, because some people are messy if you are sharing. Do be mindful of who you choose to live with in the second year if you're living in private accommodation, because when you take a contract with the house, the contract is everyone involved. So if one person breaks whatever, you're all getting charged, yeah? Okay. I didn't have to go through all of that. My friends have manners, and we know how to live together, and, you know. But that's just something you wanna, because if you're like, oh, but it wasn't me, they don't care. You guys took the contract together, so you will pay together. Yeah, guys, I think that's everything I had to say and get off my chest. Not wait to finish, like, oh. Overall, the uni is a very good experience. It's fun. It's lit. I hope my small do's and don'ts helped you guys. My mind's gone completely blank. Like, I don't even know. If you have any questions that you want me to answer, drop them down below about uni, and I'll try my best to answer and help you guys. And thank you guys for watching. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and share. Road to 1K, guys. Let's hit 1,000 subscribers before this year ends. Why not? I think we can do it. We've got like 4 months left, I think. I was right. Whew. We have 4 months left, so let's subscribe, and I'll see you in my next video.